time as 10 months. BPPM, 25 months. Then different times are time as 20 days. I'm not going to see time as upbeat, load. Questions can come. Okay, what? Surgical treatment of this time as 25 months. Another person can come. Okay, wait. But very rarely in world and all, very rarely will ask the questions. By chance, they get a chance to come as a time, I'll ask only in this time. Because nobody will answer, no? So it will be very happy. Samsa Bujur, you want to show? That means you should know something about this time. What is this time now? Ask define. Please remember it's an involuntary moment. It's an involuntary, but it's a regular moment. Regular and involuntary, to and fro movements. To and fro movements is called as diapers. Please remember the point, regular. It is rhythmic. Regular rhythmic there, yes or no? So naturally, regular, rhythmic, to and fro, involuntary. Imagine how other patient has got involuntary movements, which are not regular. Which are not rhythmic, they are called nystagmoid. They are called as nystagmoid movements. Example, they are called opsoclonus. Opsoclonus. Not sure of that, they are called bobbing. So many things are there. They are called nystagmoid movements. This is my answer. This is what basic thing are. Introduction. Next time I tell you something in nystagmus, we have got basically two movements you should know. Generally, we have got 4V18. And D4V18. What is 4V18? See, my movements are, understand now, moving my eyes to take a fixation of a particular object of interest. That are 4V18 movements. When another movement is there, I fix, at the same time some movement comes and takes it away. That's called D4V18 movements. Can be faster, whatever things slow. But basically, these are two movements are there, 4V18 and D4V18 movements. Is my knowledge to 4V18 and D4V18 movements. Puri da, hello? Next, we are telling you now. A plane of nystagmus. Horizontal, vertical, oblique, rotatory. That is, depends upon the plane. There are different types of. The nystagmus can be vertical nystagmus, horizontal nystagmus, rotatory nystagmus, oblique nystagmus. That is, depending upon the plane, we can classify. Okay, another nystagmus that we got basically we got classifications. A jerk nystagmus and a pendulum. Jerk nystagmus and pendulum nystagmus. I will tell you what is jerk. See, jerk is what known. The 4V18 D4V18 I told you. Okay, in jerk nystagmus, the D4V18 is the slow phase. I fix you, my slow phase take out. Another fast phase brings my eyes back to the positions. There's a 4V18 movement is a fast. D4V18 movement is a slow movement. That is called jerk nystagmus. Now you follow me. Then what is better than 4V18 and D4V18 both are same. Almost equal. Slow or fast. Whatever thing is there, both are equal. That is called, I'm sure now, that is called pendulum nystagmus. Jerk nystagmus. There are some other terminology you are supposed to know. Put it alright. So far I told you what, just know the meaning. What is 4V18? What is D4V18? What is jerk? What is pendulum? Then it does fall. What is nystagmus? What is nystagmoid? These things are understood. Hello? Good is that? Now, how to move man? I told you, plane. Then, see, regarding nystagmus, we have to explain the nystagmus or something or whatever the movement. In terms of amplitude, answer now, and frequency. Two things that we used to describe a patient having nystagmus. What is amplitude now? How far the eyes can move from this plane? Primary question, how far the eyes can move? Suppose 5 degrees, 15 degrees, 20 degrees, then they can move. That means what? That's why it's described as fine, coarse, large and all. Fine is what? 5 degrees. After 15 degrees course, more than 15 degrees is taken as large nystagmus. That is called amplitude of the nystagmus. Now, what is frequency now? How rapidly it goes? How rapidly? It's a slow movement or a very fast movement. That is called frequency. That's called as hello. Frequency of nystagmus and amplitude of nystagmus. Now look for this point. Now see the thing from next week. I told you about jerk and pedal. Okay, next. I told you horizontal. Now you see they've got horizontal vertical movements are there. Both are in the same patient of equal amplitude, equal frequency becomes forbid. Horizontal vertical is there. Equal amplitude, equal frequency becomes oblique nystagmus. If they are not equal, it becomes rotating. This is what the thing are supposed to know. Now to follow, sometimes patients can have only horizontal, sometimes patients can have vertical alone, but it can be combined if what? If it is equal, that is, that's called in-phase. That becomes oblique. This is what the point of they are supposed to know. Next. See, all these jerk nystagmus, now we have got what is called Alexander law. You know what is Alexander law? You don't know Alexander? You don't have this fellow's feeling? Hey! Bloody fellow! This fellow is telling that something better than you want to know. You are finished. This point was to know, I have got a fast pace line, jerk nystagmus. When I try to look towards the fast pace, my amplitude of the nystagmus will increase. The amplitude, as well as the frequency and all, will increase towards the direction of the fast phase. Suppose the fast phase is right beating. I will turn towards right side, means what? More nystagmus will be there. And that's Alexander law. And please, if I jerk nystagmus, I'm going to mention right beating, left beating, up beating, down beating, and then you know, that means what? The direction of fast phase. Suppose my fast phase is upwards, it's a beat. Please remember, fast phase is normal movement for this patient. Only the slow movement takes away from the objective interest. Now the fast movement brings it back. Actually it's a normal movement, but you're taking him, you're leveling us, this time is fast, towards fast direction. It's not upbeat, downbeat and all. That's the foveating movement, right? Hello? The eye is brought into the focus. It's a fast movement, the jump is cycles, understand now? This is what you are supposed to know. Of course, degree is not so important. Next step. Ma'am, I want to show them in paper. Slow movement means dash, dash, dash. Is an arrow. Then fast means a straight arrow. Now the amplitude I want to show now. I mean, I told you the amplitude. Amplitude, thickness of the arrow. Next to the arrow. Thickness of the arrow. Put it alone. Thick arrow, the amplitude is more. You tell me how the frequency is shown. These lines. You have to show oblique lines on the arrow. So now, there was only one oblique line, frequency is less. So many oblique lines are there on the surface, that means what it is? More frequency. Are you follow? The frequency is taken as from the oblique lines of arrow. The thickness of arrow shows the amplitude. Then upbeat means on top. Downbeat what? Down. Rotate it. Come on. Show. This frequency is called pendulum. Both are equal. Understand? Pendulum is time. Next. This is up and down. This is called rotating. This is called rotating nystagmus. We have to show the arrows like a circle, man, that's all. They are rotating nystagmus to show in the paper. This is what various diagrams to show this, what type of nystagmus the patient has got. Next. Put it alone. This is an introduction to nystagmus. Nobody will ask these questions, but basically you should know what is pendulum and what is jerk. Then jerk nystagmus, upbeat means what do you mean by upbeat? Down now what do you mean by that? Right and left means what? That's all the question can be. You need that? Now when you classify nystagmus, physiological and pathological. Physiological itself is one or two points. We have got what is called end point. So when I look this axial direction, buju, my eye is what? Keeps on oscillating. Please allow. When I see this side of my eyes are oscillating. When I see this side of my oscillating. This is of no oscillations. This my eyes will stay cold. Understand? Please ask. Why? End point this time. Because it is in the center. Understand how it is called end point this time. Another thing is octogonic this time. That's also physiological. Another thing is that irrigations. Cold water, warm water and all. அப்பா அந்த போத்தியஸ் கோல்ட் வாட்டர் கப்புக்க பண்ற கவுஸ் கோல்ட் வாட்டர் ஆப்போசிட் மாம்ஸ்டேட் மாமடர் ஸ்டேட் பாஸ்டேஜ் கோல்டு வாட்டர் ஆப்போசிட் மீன்ஸ் ஃபாஸ்ட் பேஸ்ட் டுவர்ஸ் ஆப்போசிட் சைட் வாமடர் ஸ்டேட்னாக்க ஃபாஸ்ட் பேஸ்ட் டுவர்ஸ் சைட் கோல்டு வாட்டர் போத் இயர்ஸ்னா அப்லிஸ்ட் ஆகினால் ஃபாஸ்ட் பேஸ்ட் டுவர்ஸ் ஆப் டோட்டல் ஒவ்வொரு கப்பு கப்பு யூ பிகம் அ கப் ஆஃப் 6 மந்த்ஸ் ஹலோ புரியுதா திஸ் ஆர் ஆல் வாட் திஸ் ஆர் ஆல் இங்கிலீஷ் டாக்டர்ஸ் இட்ஸ் கால் கலோரிக் கலோரிக் டிஸ்ட்ராக்டர்ஸ் திஸ் ஆர் ஆல் கலோரிக் ஃபிசியோலாஜிக்கல் ஏ பிரச்சனை நம்ம காம் நவ வாட் யூ ஆர் டிஸ்ட்ராக்டர்ஸ் தி ஷார்ட் டர்ம் காம்ஸ் After coming this time, what's happening here? See now, I'm looking here somewhere, the Buddha comes in here. Suddenly my eyes are stoned. That means why my frontal lobe is telling, hello, you see the Buddha has come. After instructing me, my eyes are moving very fast. And fixes Buddha up. Now the Buddha is moving this time. I am following, that's called pursuit. And then, that's called pursuit moment. That means what? First, the frontal lobe is instructing for a saccadic movement. Once it is fixed, I am going to follow the movement. Understand how it's called pursuing. That pursuing movement is from where? Starting from occipital lobe only, but it has to pass through parietal lobe. All of you must be knowing parietal lobe. Remember that one? Hello? Say, I wish you, Ram. You are moving, Ram. I might move my eyes. Suddenly, this girl comes. Nagpur, huh? Nagpur. Thak. Moves. It's on. Fast is slow. Fast is slow. That is called optimal Krishna. That is what you want. One pursuit and one saccadic. The saccadic is timer. Please. Saccadic is called this timer now. The fast pace. But it has to take this what now? Your area is 18 and 19 is optimal low. Not the area 17. Area 17 is visual cortex. Straight area. But for this impulse passing from 18 and 19, parasite and base area, passing through parietal lobe and comes to your pons for the case center, for the horizontal case center is coming. That's why in parietal lobe lesions, this pursuit movement pathway is lost. Imagine now, I fixed Ram. He is going, I am not able to follow her. That means my eye is not moving. Then, when the eye's pursuit movement is not there, how can I have next circuit? That is called optimal distractors is absent in a case of parietal lobe problems. It is called as optoparietal nystagmus sign positive. What is sign positive? Nystagmus absent. In parietal lobe lesions, the optoparietal nystagmus sign is positive. The common example is when I ask you, what is sign positive? I will ask you. If an answer is optoparietal nystagmus sign is positive, means it is absent. You cannot elicit the nystagmus just by rotating a drum. It's a physiological phenomenon. Understand now? A question may come. Optogenic drum. If you get a chance to set a paper, I will put a paper, put a picture, write something about a drum. What do you write, man? What do you write? This is called optogenic drum. To elicit the nystagmus, which is a physiological phenomenon. When parietal problem is can be demonstrated, you see now your technology is. Then if suppose a patient is malingering, you can find out the problems. And suppose the child is there, you can find out the vision is gone or not. That's all the things you can find out. Hello? But drum no puttani can ask you questions. Imagine you are appearing for a passage, man. Drum will come and tell, hello, what is this? Drum will come on. Demonstrate this time as a patient. Imagine he has got a great hemianopia. Hemianopia because of retinal lesions. This time will be absent or present. I am asking you a question. Hemianopia, the problem is in the retina. Problem is it? Retina, this nystagmus can be elicited or not? And I lose only parietal lobe after that area only we can demonstrate. Otherwise it can elicit the nystagmus. The lesion is not retina. That's not the question. Retinal lesions, you may be having appearing as hemianopic problems, but still you can elicit the nystagmus. A classical question in examination, if I come as examiner. Only thing nobody will give a chance. Sanja, hello Rajasthan, worst, not studying properly. Gujarat Purida, in retinal lesions, hello, retinal lesions, hemianopia is there, but still you can elicit this diagnosis. Whereas in the federal problems, somewhere you can take, you cannot. Now the other question, common exam question you must be knowing in occupational research. What is that? Kokam dittam dhima, you know. You don't know. Kokam dittam no one is here. Dittam. Kokam C-O-G-N. Kokam dittam. I will tell you. I am having a problem in area 17. A vascular lesion stopped. Area 17 is damaged. 18 and 19, okay. I can rotate the numb, I can increase the disciples. And you follow. Imagine now I am having a tumor starting in 17. Initially tumor is there in volume only 17. 18 is okay, 19 is okay, I can increase the disciples. Once the tumor is increasing in size, other areas will be involved. So the disciples will be absent. It may involve the turtle also, the tumor can increase in size. That means this is a victim. In a case of occipital oblations, if you are able to elicit the nystagmus initially, later on the nystagmus is not able to elicit, it is a case of tumor, occipital tumor, then victim. Kulida, na, repeat. You must explain English, proper English, come on. Even English class also that thing. Come on. In a case of occipital problem, if the nystagmus can be elicited initially and later on not able to elicit, means it is a tumor lesion. In the case of occipital problems, initially you can elicit, later on also you can elicit, elicit, elicit always. It is a bloody vascular lesion. You can't get them. You can find all these things, man. Hey, after this time, what I can tell, Kokam's dictum can be found out. You can find out occipital problems, then you can write. So the two pages can go over. You can draw the diagram of the drum also, one page. Answer now. Hello? Santa? You are Vastra. You are also Vastra. All Vastra candidates are there. Why you are bad Vastra? This is the law. Okay. This as far as optical nystagmus is concerned. Then a caloric nystagmus is also the physiological. Then coming to pathological nystagmus, we have got few things done. You should know that. See, we have got a sensory problem, we can give a nystagmus. A motor problem can give a nystagmus. You want a pelvic problem, it's a motor problem only. A pelvic problem, absolute tumor, not a motor problem. A superman problem, all the rational. Psychiatric one, this movement, these are called motor problems. Want to follow? Then you have got another thing is the nystagmus can be associated with pain. Childhood spindle now you must be knowing, they can have nystagmus. Then something else like spasmus, glucans and also many things. And the miscellaneous characters. You have got some alternating nystagmus. So many things are there. All the things are not required as no things. How to classify means physiological pathology. Hello. Physiological means endpoint nystagmus, optokinetic and colic. Whereas pathological means maybe motor problem, maybe sensory problem, maybe after the spin, maybe miscellaneous areas. Miscellaneous means you have got right about alternating nystagmus and spasmus, glucans and all, chintulna. This was a broad classification of nystagmus. Understand now? Well, Purida, next about it.
Hey, okay,
next, then the things I am doing now. There are certain things I told you step one, but we will tell you that problem. So, in the case of the body, some localized factors. See, a nystagmus is not just a problem. This is a problem for his patient. This is an area of lesion. Whether it can easily get just for localizations. Localization, understand now? See, now childhood nystagmus, classical. See, I mean, child has got nystagmus. Okay, when you examine, from the beginning, such a child is 1 month old child. Child has got nystagmus. That means what? They will have definitely some sensory problems. They will have macular not developed. Great plan, yeah. Something will be there. What do you follow? Puriya Rava, sensory problems can be detected in this way, child. Another child, that means what? When a child has got nystagmus, at the age of 1 month, definitely it will have some sensory problems. Then they can come to a conclusion. Another child is there, which somewhere, when you cover one eye, the nystagmus is more. In the uncovered eye, the missing eye. And you follow, when you shift the cover to the other eye, nystagmus will be more in this unconcerned eye. Fixing eye. That is, the nystagmus will be beating towards the
fixing it. Suppose I cover my left eye, fast reach towards the right side. The right eye only open, then reach something fast. I cover the right eye now, the left eye will beat. These are what now manifest data that is in the world. So if you see an experiment like this, you know this patient has got essential infantilization of the eyes. Although for the patient, what you can find out the problem. When cover one eye, miss that increasing in one other eye, that means what you are dealing with the case of, most probably in the case of essential esophagus. Another change has come. This happens there, what is the same as the form of me? Now the child has got head nodding also. Head nodding is there, at the same time this time is also there, it is fast or smooth damage. Mostly, but you have to investigate. Fast person in patient are, he will have torticollis, he will have head nodding, all the problems may be associated. But this is why you have to investigate and rule out other conditions. Once you have ruled out other conditions, once you have ruled out what other conditions, what will happen now? You can tell, yes, this case of past pressure damage. You have ruled out other conditions, and that means what? You have come to a conclusion, yes, this is a case of past pressure damage. What is the importance now? Past pressure damage is not it starts at 1 year of age, but it's a case by 3 years. That means you do not worry about the patient. So it is good enough. That is the localizing that. Hello? Another patient has come, one eye problem that, often now gliomas, they can have distractors. So unilateral distractors, you have to suspect some problem, like optic nerve gliomas. One eye alone moving around the syndrome, you can have optic nerve gliomas, you can have chiasma problems, you can have ventricular problems. That means a child has come to you, there is one eye only moving. That means what you have to rule out these problems. They are localizing values. Wonderful, that means localization in the case of child distractors. Another distractor is vestibular distractors. You know vestibular distractors? Vestibular, huh? Hey, you know sometimes some exam question, where is the problem that you go to open your eye and go see whatever you know? You tell vestibular practice, cerebellum, midbrain. Pons, brain stuff, that's how it goes. Where's the problem? Brain sensor. Nobody can argue with you. If that's the problem, maybe you say whatever brain sensor. Who they are? Or maybe in the vestibular group there, so who knows? So now, where is the reason? Sandhya, where is the reason? I have not asked you anything. Where is the reason of brainstorm? Muslim, suppose you ask her, next time, when I must tell brainstorm. So where is the reason of brainstorm? Sandhya, that means, next time, must I usually be on this area, because they are all coordinating her. Vestibular nucleus, vestibular apparatus, then go to brainstorm, then cerebellum, all things are connected. There are integrating centers. Naturally, whenever any problem associated, then naturally you have this diagnosis. Very follow. This is what you're supposed to know. See now, vestibular apparatus problems. See, vestibular, already I told you how it is, please remember. The now, you have a same problem can arise in vestibular apparatus, peripherals, and then peripheral distractors. Peripheral, you know what? They got irritating vision or something destructive vision. Destruction around, your tumor is there. Your vessel around, tumor is there. Or something like this. These are destructing and destroying the fibers. Whereas irritation means what? Something irritating, for example, Meniere's disease. Meniere's disease. There are irritating lesions. But how to understand, how to know what type of mistake the patient will have? Always remember, destruction means cold water. Hello? Destruction on the neck. Irritating on the neck. Warm water, same person, warm water, so. A destructive lesion, what problem the patient can have, not have, just like cold water, opposite. Irritating lesion produces what problem? Warm water, same thing, this type of system. But follow up, very easy to understand, very easy to make that. Irritating enough, sorry, true, you know that? Sorry, true. Hey, where's the problem, huh? Salaki Aruba. You are Aruma, you know Sorichu. Sorichu, what? Sorichu. Sorichu. You don't know, you are Maya, no? Sorichu, you know. Teaching. Irritating. Good to put it, yeah, hello. Your understanding is what? When you have an irritating condition, it's a very warm water. When you have a disruptive condition, that's like a cold water, that's all. Okay, another point is important. You see, they will ask you, it is in vestibular nerve. I is in the nucleus. Our brains have taken us to the response central. They will ask how to differentiate. See, my married vessel in a peripheral is time, sir. This cold water, whatever is there. I fix at you, this time has diminished. This time has diminished. Fixing Anshanam will inhibit the time mass. When I settle this time mass, I fix your whole this time mass, I will vomit on you. If you are having a subtle problem, hey, your father is well. Mangi one is on your head. That is what central nystagmus fixation will aggravate, whereas peripheral nystagmus fixation will diminish. But another way of telling the same thing in different manner. When it close eye, nystagmus increase in the peripheral. So fixation diminish like that, close it will diminish when it does not show. You will follow. Okay, yeah. That means what? Fixation diminishes, means closing of the eye or covering the eye aggravate of problem. In the case of peripheral nystagmus, always just when fixing will decrease. In the case of peripheral nystagmus. See, another thing of my differentiating peripheral nystagmus, I tell you, I'm not shaking. Okay, I'll ask them, I'll come and ask questions. I start, keep on moving like this, you keep moving. Then cover. When you fix it like a peripheral is diminishing, I told you. You cover the eye, you will never have this time as well. As you are shaking, cover. What this time as you have? What is all you shaking? Tap. Two this time is hard. Your answer is place number opposite. Opposite is the fast place towards opposite side. Suppose I have the right side problem, the right side vessel problem, peripheral problem. I shake like this and cover, I will get a fast place, opposite directions. Just like a cold water man. If you are doing what this time, what you are doing? Hey, not doing. You are doing this. Let this know. And what your hair is shaking? Vertical. Vertical is shaking. Imagine I have a peripheral problem. Cover. What this time must you get? Hey, you told her, I'm thinking being a horizontal, cover, opposite. Vertical, that's what you agreed with me. Yes. Now I assure you, right? What this time was you get? In peripheral visions of the similar matters, your answer is same side nystagmus, warm water. Puriyara? Vertical head shaking will produce same side fast pace. Horizontal head shaking will produce opposite nystagmus. Same sir. Head shaking, huh? Hey, head movements. Horizontal. I cover. This side must towards the same. Opposite side. I do like this. Cover. This side must towards the same side. Fast pace. Suppose I'm having a right side problem. Vessel or spiritual problem. I will have this side must towards the same side. Otherwise, warm water this side must. Hello? Pulida? You mean central nation? Central vision, horizontal, dandangan, nystagmus, what nystagmus? Hey, central lesions. So far I have told you only peripheral problem, this will happen. Horizontal head shaking will produce opposite. Vertical head shaking will produce same as nystagmus. This is what is true. The example of what I have done. Then central lesions. This is your nuclear lesions. Horizontal shaking will produce what nystagmus? Your answer is ham also. What is that? Down this time must not be seen. Down this time must be produced. Central lesions are. As our lesion, this time is the same thing to start. Downward. Sometimes I am unsure. Fully I am having a brainstem problem. I am making a movement of my head there, not peripheral lesions. I will develop this when this time is downbeat in this time. The disciple is fast pace towards downside. Who is that? Hey. Samjha? Peripheral vestibular lesions and central vestibular lesions are differentiating now. Peripheral vestibular lesions, fixation will diminish. Is that understood? Central lesions, fixation, aggravate a problem. Now, peripheral lesions, horizontal head shaking, will produce nystagmus. What disciples have also received the revelation opposite. As this was of this like a cold water. Vertical action will produce same vision. Disciples. If it's a central vision, when the nuclear and all problem is there, even vision is what if I do a horizontal head shaking, this time it will be down the thing. You know, what is that answer? Down the inner, the disciples down, fast face over down side. That is differentiating. You follow? This is what is called vestibular apparatus problems. Are you following this point? Make sure God, other disciples, classically you should know one thing. Benign paroxysmal, you know that. Positional disciples. BPPN. Benign paroxysmal positional disciples. What is that, you know? See, maybe in case of labyrinthitis, like this, so many problems may be there. I will tell you what's happening in the patient. Imagine now, we have got some manuals. Do like this, get down positions. Down head, like this. This kind of all. Like head, you know the position names? Nylon Barney. Nylon Barney position prayer, huh? Like this, no, like this. You don't know. Thick halpike, you don't know. Thick halpike. And there are manuals in the head to induce the disciples, that's all. Hello? These are all the manuals here, the guy. Not for us, but we have got some, they will have to check where the muscle apparatus and all, just turn the head like this, turn the head, and see what's happening to the brain, all these things happen. I'm sure this is called manuals. What is benign of their plasma is what? These patients, they have got something wrong. You know we have got autoconia? Autoconia, you know? Water lips and all. And so now, you know we have got utricle? Then we have got sexual canals. See, we have got basically what's happening in the BPN. There are some materials inside the utricle. And so now, when you move here, you know what happens? These materials, they come out. They enter the sexual canal. Now the patient develops this time. Now the patient develops what? Vertical movements arise. Because this, they are called as autoconia, isn't it? Autoconia, these materials are coming out of the utricle and they enter the sacral canals. That's why cupola and cupola. These metals can go and get attached to cupola. That's why cupola lithiasis, just like stone by the cupola lithiasis. That's why cupola lithiasis. That means what? When they come there, you get disciples. That means for that to overcome, they will do forcefully kill the head like this, forcefully. Now the materials will go back again to the utricle. This time is out to become normal. You know the name of the manual? Of course, we are not doing it. Epley's manual, EPLEY. Epley's manual to overcome the DPPN. Hello? Epley's, you have to follow and all DPPN short notes, 10 marks. You write some nonsense. What aconia, what do you say, semi-sacral canal, cupola, utricle, you mention some names. Normally from utricle, these materials can come out, they enter semi-sacral canal, then the patient gets a problem. If you move the materials again back into the utricle, by just doing every maneuver, it becomes a problem. Are you follow? With that DPPN, but when I fix, the problem gets alleviated. Please remember, BPPN, when I fix them, I will still have more problems. You may have experienced it sometimes, you have not experienced so far. Don't worry, after 2 years you will experience. Every one of us may be experiencing that. Suddenly, you know, I have experienced, after you enter the world, you will move around, I must not see that. You will get nausea, vomiting, everything that. Then you take it close and then lie down. You will start seeing, you know, there are again more problems. And then again, one thing. The person, yeah, they used to work in tablets. And then, you might have heard Sujiran working, and then they used to steroids also. There are sometimes, this may be a sort of indicator or something, labyrinthitis, something, inflammations. That's why they give steroids also, along with that. Then I got confused, I was getting this one, I was thinking about so many things. அவர்தான் பிரம்மாயி வைத்தினை. Then I went and bought my MRI, everything became normal. Then I told you something behind, so chapter goes. And follow me. The 2 days of mental torture only began. Then I started reading all the textbooks, and this week began open. I couldn't understand what was in them. I started reading EMT, all the books. So this thing, deeply clear. Now other disciples have got, please remember, speech on disciples. When I go up, other day comes down, then it's much growing. When I go up, one other day comes down. If you see a case of disease of disciples, the problem is comparing parakayasma. Parakayasmatic region. That is what localizing out. I told you central disciples, vesicular central, vesicular peripheral. Then I told you chinostigmas, BPP and a major problem, I told you now. Now, see the means my major problem, parakayasma region. The problem is there. If I get an upbeat nystagmus, the problem is where close your eyes, put what? Brain cell, midbrain. See that? Say well now. You write down nonsense. Upbeat nystagmus. Downbeat nystagmus? For a magnum. Again the brain assembly, medulla, spinal cord, this area. All monkey and all patients. Suppose you doubt yourself, maybe anticonvulsant about it, nothing wrong. Magnesium deficiency, vitamin B deficiency, lithium toxicity, whatever it comes across, you grab by the diagnosis of it. These are the problems you can give rise to. Upbeat nystagmus, problems occurring midbrain. See, we call one syndrome called fine knot syndrome. Have you heard? Midbrain syndrome, not the midbrain syndrome, they can produce upbeat nystagmus. Now the question is what? How to elicit the brain nystagmus? You got a drum. Hello, they are drum. They are drum. Imagine, this is a drum given to you. This is a drum given to you. You will rotate the drum, which reaction to get the brain elicit nystagmus. Come on. Nystagmus, you elicit now. Upbeat nystagmus, you elicit. In which direction I will rotate the drum? Hey. Drum, you know, we have got some drum only, we have got stripes there. See, the stripe is that, stripe is that, stripe is like this. Now, I see this stripe, look down, suddenly I can look up. Look down, suddenly like that is what? I have to rotate the drum downwards. Stripes are like this drum. You rotate only, the next stripe will come. That is what? If you get an upbeat nystagmus, I will look at this stripe and follow it. That's the drum. That means the drum has been rotated. Downwards, then FRCS question. FRCS name, they will give this drum. They will ask you, you want to get it upbeat nystagmus? The drum has to be rotated in which direction, they will ask you. Always to get it, whatever direction is, move in opposite direction. The drum has to be rotated downwards. Are you follow? Very, the FRCS question, I know that. You don't want to pay the FRCS now. You want that out? How do you agree? This is what you are supposed to know. This is what upbeat nystagmus, downbeat, localizing. Okay? These are various things in these areas. Now we have got another nystagmus there, gaze evoked nystagmus. Gaze evoked. See now, I am moving like this. I am not able to maintain my eye. In the day there, now the eye comes back to like this. Again I move to maintain. Come back. Again I move. That is called gaze frantic nystagmus or gaze evoked nystagmus. Here what's now the gaze holding mechanisms are defective. Hello integrator, I call integrators. That means I have to move my eyes, I have to maintain the gaze here. And when I will maintain, I am moving like this. Again to maintain, I am moving like this. Nystagmus. And you follow. That is called gaze bending nystagmus because of the gaze holding mechanisms are effective. That is why I am predicting nystagmus of gaze bending or gaze hold. There are certain things you should know this. If I find a gaze of nystagmus, what do you mean by that? The little integrity, arm ligament, cerebellum, palms and all. That means a problem is about the area, that's all. I will follow this point. These are all the various nystagmus man. Look at that. Now you see now, nystagmoid. I already told you, nystagmoid. So please remember, distant mind, and one more thing is there about saccadic intrusions. Saccadic intrusion. Oh, but distant mind, I told you, but just distant mind, a slow movement taking away, the fast movement prefixes. That means the problem, some bad associated with slow movement only. In saccadic intrusion, it's a saccadic movement problem. Hello? Saccadic system, the fast system. There's a problem in the saccadic system is responsible for saccadic intrusions. What is saccadic intrusion? See, the defoliating is saccades. Bringing all the saccades. That's saccadic intrusion. Hello? Saccadic intrusion, the defoliating movement is also saccades. Foliating movement is also saccades. But what is the difference about nystagmus and all the things I tell you now, the second one now? See, saccadic intrusions. Defoliating, that stops that for some time, then comes back. Stops. That means what? First movement takes it away, then remain there for some time, and then come back again. That is called a saccadic interval. That is called a saccadic interval. The saccadic intrusions will have saccadic intervals. The classical phenomenon of saccadic intrusions. See, that stops. Then the surface moves, stops there for about few seconds, then comes back. That's saccadic intrusions. Put it along. Saccadic interval is there. Well, good luck. Samja. Fast pace, this time, mainly for slow movement also problem is there. Here, I'm fixing you. A fast movement takes my issue, this is that girl. Software for some time. Then I get reset. Then take it. I will follow. That interval is there. Whereas other things like oscillations, understand how? In a ball is made up of oscillations, therefore oscillations. There are no intersaccadic intervals. There is no intersaccadic, that is the saccadic intrusion matter. The fast phase takes it, stops there, then again fast phase brings it. Whereas in oscillations, like normal bobbing and all, fast phase of whatever thing takes it. Again comes back, takes it, again comes back like this. There is no interval. But I know the meaning now. You will understand the difference now. In saccadic intrusions, the vision is somewhat better for the patient. Second thing, the outside world will not move. Whereas in oscillations, outside world will move, vision is reduced. Are you follow? Well, oscillations, there are two things called ocular flutter and ocular protuberance. Samja? Oscillations, ocular flutter, and horizontal movements. Oxoprolonus are chaotic movements. Oblique, rotating like this, so many movements are oxoprolonus. See, please remember now, we are talking about nystagmus, intersaccadic, and of course saccadic intrusions, then oscillations. Oscillations, there are two things. One is ocular flutter and oxoprolonus. Hello? Oxoprolonus. The difference what? Intersaccadic interval is not there here. That means what? Here the patient is diminished. And they will have oscillopsia, and their body is moving around for the patient. Whereas the intersaccadic interval is there in the saccadic intrusions, no oscillopsia. Vision is okay for the patient. There are differences. In saccadic interval, there is about, there was square wave jerks. Cut, come back. Cut, come back. And a square wave jerks in the brain. Square wave jerks. Hey, square wave jerks. Square wave jerks. By now the question comes, saccadic intrusion can pass. At least right, a square wave, intersaccadic interval, no oscillops here, vision is okay. Then they can write. Why? Oscillations, no intersaccadic interval, oscillops here, vomiting here, but they go, this way, good, that's all. That's not horizontal, also known as chaotic movements. Then difference are. Now what is body now? Up and down. That happens in coma patients. Don't tell, vision is normal. Hello? If you are after vomiting for them, vision will be normal, don't write. Vision will be diminished also, you can't tell, it's a coma. It's got to say. She said, we hit his arm, she said, after bombing. Bombing, okay, that is that. In what those patients, like point 10 problems, point 11, there were some problems. After bombing will be there. You know bombing? Not Bobby, bombing. First step, fast down. That's slow movement. Fast down, slow movement up. We learn that means what? Fast comes down, slow movement and back to primary portions. Again, that's the something that goes on. Without any patient or patient all is going to move. And the ocular bob being in a quick. Understand now? Down with the regular, regular laugh. Hey, this is a listed mind. I did told you, right? This is a listed mind. Keep it in the left. Slow up. Of course, here is that. And then we are telling Bobby. Now, slow, cut the faster. Slow, cut the faster. After. Inverse Bobby, do so. Hey, that's inverse Bobby. I put them dipping in there. Hello, that's called dipping. Dipping, hello. Dipping or inverse Bobby. Put that. Hey, Rajasthan, inverse Bobby. Now I ask the more question, hello. Instead of coming down, tuck it, up. Tuck it. Both up and come down. That's not what? You will hold some pizza. You are ready. Come on. Canvas bobbing. Tell me. Canvas bobbing. Hey, canvas bobbing. So they got three bobbing, sir. One is upper bobbing normal. Another is inverse bobbing, another is converse bobbing. Inverse and then bobbing and then fast down, then slow. Inverse and then slow down and up and down and converse. Bobbing. Goes up and comes down. Whatever faster, going up and coming down is converse. Going down only, first start going down is bobbing. Another faster position of bobbing. Slow up, but different. I'm going to tell you in words. What all these problems are bad now? They are comatose patients. You know, they don't tell you the exact person of the world. They are comatose patients, which we can't understand at all. The problem is a very important. If you don't understand, there are localized conditions. It's quite understood. Yeah, with that, next photo. I told you about making all these things. Vector knowledge. Psychiatric intervention, I told you. In the psychiatric intervention, all spinal wave injection, all I told you. Remember? Next, I told you about the various characteristic features. Down with that, as a patient problem. Remember all these things? Hey, I already explained all these things. Just you can leave it together, everything I described. Next, now the question is what? See, I have the original problem I told you. Child, what I'm talking about, this is how the situation is in the brain is imperfect. See, we have an angelic attack. Problem, disclaimers, retinal blastoma, disclaimers, macular problem, disclaimers, if there's a macular disclaimers, I will follow. That is what code disturbing disclaimers. Is there a sensitive problem? This is the brain is imperfect. I'm telling now the patient got posterior pathways. Imagine now a problem, don't bother about what are problems. You want the optimal disclaimers, what are problem? Sensory problem reaching the brain, a visual cortex is not reaching the properly. Many problems are there in parallel problems or the man of the what type of disturbance is that? With a question, hey, retina problem, disturbance is that? Retina anti visual pathway. Reaching the top. From retina, only the pupils is reaching the top of the globe. Now, a problem affecting anti visual pathway will produce disturbance. Sensory problems. Now the synthetic problems of the posterior visual pathway produce what? This time, I'm asking you.
Where are you going?
Hey, where are you? Come on. You want to go this time, why not? Come on. You definitely might this time also, come on. I ask a question, you tell man. I'm here, over.
Twenty-five.
What did you order? Update another. Now please do not reject. Please remember, post your visual pathway, sedentary problem, never to miss the service. Wait. Look at that. That's why he mentioned. If you know, nothing is wrong. Everything is wrong, sir. Hello, your answer is posterior visual pathway, sensory problem is there. Because the pathway is not connecting properly. You will never get nystagmus. What is anterior visual pathway problem? Sensory problem will have nystagmus. Don't get confused with water. If you have water, sir, okay, impossible, don't tell. And the point of the case, posterior visual pathway, sensory problems will never produce that is what? Nystagmus. Is that English known? English word, right? See, what's happening, you know, they are explaining like this. They have problems starting from anterior pathway. Then they have the problem starting. Because the problem is there. Brain is not getting a proper impulse. Now brain telling, hey, kya ho gaya? Dhundo. Anterior visual pathway, brain is sending now. Posterior visual pathway is telling it. Hello, you don't have time to see something. Nystagmus coming. And the follow. That means the posterior visual pathway is directing the anterior visual pathway to search for the vision. If a problem is affecting the posterior visual pathway, who will ask the posterior visual pathway to search it? Only after hours and only will come and research. Genital body. Who is that? The posterior visual pathway sensory problem is there now. You look at the nystagmus. That means when your problem are down, this time is why posterior something like comparison. I don't take it seriously. English only. Because it is written like this in textbooks. Because I found this sentence very nicely, that's why I got this question. Because posterior visual pathway directing the anterior visual pathway to search for the object. That's why the nystagmus is created. It's coming. Whereas there is a lesion in the posterior visual pathway, who will ask the posterior visual pathway to search it? An anterior cannot tell, posterior from here. Now who will tell? From outside, only you tell this body of support. From here. Next supporter. Nothing. Treatment nothing in the reverse of treatment also. No. Don't tell treatment is nothing. But very easy to understand now, very easy to understand the basics. Of course, medical treatment, non-surgical, is not so significant. They can give a botulinum, they can give a prism, whatever thing is the occlusion for the ends. But surgical treatment is most important for you to take the exams. Is there? It's not there. I'll tell you now. We want basically what the treatment I'm telling you. We have got modified cast and bomb. Is that there? Modified cast and bomb. KS. TAM. BAUM. Cast and bomb. BAUM. Wait. Cast and KSTN bomb. BAUM. Cast and bomb. That is one of the data. I'm going to talk about the old piece. That's what I mean. Did only 5 millimeter for all the muscles. Irrespective of resection, resection, whatever thing is there, resection, resection, whatever thing is there, he was doing only 5 millimeter. But what now? He was preparing everything for all the four muscles, abdominal muscles. Resection, resection, all are done. Both are done. Anderson came. Anderson came. Hey, why are they all? He said, I will do only resections. I will do? I will be selling. I will do only the section. Then another fellow came. Boto, you know Boto. One fellow Boto came. He told, why the section, man? I will do only the sections. The section. So Caston Bond did the both. The section, the section. Whereas Anderson did the only the sections. Boto comes and do one what? Only the sections. and one other came. I will do something like this. People are here, my brothers are coming. Put it like now, receptions are idle now. Waste space. They have got, you know, fast space. You know, fast space or not? Fast space run. Right bidding. Right bidding is like that. Please remember. Normally, what you will have room, they will try to turn the head towards the left side. Please remember, the head posture, everything will be adopted. They will understand what the aim of this study is. Please remember, suppose you ask, aim of study. See, you got what is called null point. Null point is absolutely distinguished from this. That means null point will be anywhere. That means our idea is what? To bring the null point in the primary position, circular position. That's the basic idea of doing surgery is what? To bring the null point to the primary position. For example, they will ask you. This type of study in Naga was a basic principle Naga. Your answer is to bring the null point to the primary position. Next, sometimes patient adopts adduction. Adduction improves in this type of study again. So to produce the adduction in the patient, I'm sure now, to produce adduction in the patient is a disciple of this depression. That's also the aim. Then you do something so that you may not diminish, you may not diminish this type of totally, you may not abolish, but you can reduce the amplitude. That means what? You can reduce the amplitude. The aim of surgery is what? One, to take the null point to primary. Two, induce adduction in the patient. And three, to reduce the amplitude. There are 3 points right like that. Surgery. And then, hello, aim of surgery is this point also. That means what? That's the form, it is. That is, I will tell you, easy to understand. Suppose, imagine now, I am having head down towards the left side. Head down towards the left side. Head down towards the left side. My eye will be there, where? Right eye here. Left eye here. Right eye is attracting. Left eye is attracting. Why do you follow? Why? Now this right leg attack is there, that means what? That muscle you build. Weaken. Weaken the muscle. Now this is what? This is an adduction. You weaken the middle leg, that's all. Otherwise, alone. Otherwise, still easy to understand. Remember, the fast pace towards right side. That is moving. That is what? My right leg attacks and the left leg is moving fast. You better slow down. Weaken the muscle, that's all. Weaken the muscle. In the right middle distractors, right leg rectus and the left middle rectus are weakened. Then this right middle rectus, other two muscles are strengthened, that's all. So, that's the muscle you want now, all the muscles. And that's the muscle you want in the sessions. What the muscle doing? Both. Tell you, they are doing what? 5-6. I should have maximum 5 mm for it. Another fellow came. Only 5 millimeter. Another fellow came and told, hey, 5, 6, 7, 8, put it. A rule. 5, 6, 7, 8, you know that. 5 millimeter is number middle test as a chance. Middle test can be assessed. Please, by the second, take it. 5 millimeter means strengthening is 6 millimeter. Let that test, until now, 7 means weakening, 8 is strengthening. Recession always come back, mistakes. 5, 6, 7, 8 rule means 5 middle letters. Now 6 also middle letters. 5 recession, 6 is resection. 7, 8, 7 recession of that letter, 8 is resection of that letters. Strengthening principles. This is all 5, 6, 7, 8 rule I have resolved. Hello, what do you call 5, 6, 7, 8? Another fellow came, I know, I will do 6, 7, 8 like this. They are not like that. Just know things, they have got some rule. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, why should I go? I have got a different group of ideas. You are my friends, our ideas. They were doing what? No, no, no. I will do only 2, 3 relations. 2, 3 ratios. What 2, 3 ratios? Middle letters 2, letters 3. Middle letters 2, letters 3. That is what I tell you. Suppose I am doing 5 millimeter middle letters. Either resection or resections. Let us do how much now? 7.5. 5 into 2 parts now. 7.5 3 parts. So if I do 5 millimeter per middle letters, I will do 7.5 per letter. These are the 2-3 rule. 2-3 ratios. Suppose I do 6 millimeter, how much do? 6 millimeter, letter is how much, huh? 6 into 2 parts, apna kya hoga matlab 3 parts hai 9 that's all meter 6 na kya hai 9 ila 2 3 ratio so 5 na 7.5 hai 6 na kya 9 millimeter that's the ratio they have got a ratio of 2 3 we know what regarding directions and directions ila na basically for this number Anderson, at least know the names, man. Kassenbaum's, Anderson, Borto, Van Noorden, our names in William Schneider. Until I'm in relation to what? I'll solve the problems. Now we have got vertical stagmas. Very easy to know about this now. Vertical stagmas is the law. I'll put a vertical Kassenbaum's there, vertical Kassenbaum's. Very easy to know, I'll tell you. Suppose, normal hour in participant and all, when looked in depression, which person is paralyzed, huh? When you do my head, that is, chin depression, to overcome the look here, what muscle is paralyzed? Which muscle is paralyzed? Right? Chin depression occurs which direction, huh? When the depression is paralyzed, chin elevation, which muscle is paralyzed? When the elevation is paralyzed, that means that a paralyzed muscle is what? Where to strengthen? In this case, please remember, where to strengthen? Opposite muscle is weak. Weaker, eventually now, chin is depressed, not depressed out there. Depressed out, that's allowed. That means what? Depressed is what you can act as. You have to strengthen that. Superior actors are true. Weaker, please, even if I am in chin depressed, eye is wrong, right? Eye is going up only. Eye don't regret. Are you follow? Why? Chin elevated, there is the muscle, the very high ball, so going down only. You better kick at the muscle. Chin depressed na kya hai? Depressed na out mein hai. Chin is elevated na kya? Elevated na out. That's why you're moving the chin. That means out means what? That muscle is weak, strength and body. Opposite muscle is weak and body. You follow? Just like I told you, but you can cast them out. What do you make now? Depending upon chin depression, you can do the studies. Or chin elevation, you can do the studies. But maximum you can do only 4 millimeter. Maximum you can do only 4 millimeter. Understand now? Why? Right? Vertical Kassenbaum, you understand now? Then you have got one of the other thing is there, oblique Kassenbaum. Oblique, you know, not oblique. Oblique Kassenbaum, no, that's very important. See, what's oblique now? You have got equation, exertion, and problems. See, imagine now, I have a chin, my head tilted. See, here chin I told you. Now the head is tilted towards the right shoulder. Head is tilted towards the right shoulder. What treatment? Mr. is there, head is, position is there, then head is tilted towards the right shoulder. Three options available. One, hazard rectus muscle to be corrected. That will be the rectus. Then superior inferior can be corrected. And superior inferior can be corrected. Three muscles are going to rush out, three different muscles are going to tackle. Very easy to rush out. When my head is tilted towards the right shoulder, don't think at all nonsense. You just know what they are doing. Chin, that is head is tilted to a right shoulder, your answer, that leg is okay, that leg is top. You hear it? For an instruction, you take it up. When the leg is taken up, now the period has come, it has to come down. This right hand is around, movement going up, now period is taken down. This side, period is taken up. Another sign is this, now that leg is taken down, that's all. Tilted towards right shoulder, right lateral start with it, starting. Lateral is go up, middle come down. Left middle is go up, middle is come down. Lateral is that's all. Go up, come down. Go up, come down. That's all. Why? Same way, superior rectus is wrong. Very easy. Tilted towards right shoulder. Superior rectus, move easily. Hello? Superior rectus, move easily. I'm inferior rectus is wrong. Temporally. This side, superior rectus, move temporally. Same direction you have to move, man. The right side of the nasal. Left side is towards this side, and the same side that you are moving towards the direction now. But temporal. Hey, you know, I know anywhere. Kya ho gaya na? Explain one minute. You will have confusion. just know, of course, you have to weaken, and you take the land next to all, you're going to weaken the area. That's what's going to happen. And we follow. That is superior actors, near the lead. அப்படின்னா இந்த சைடு சூப்பர் பிளாட் சூப்பர் அட்ஜஸ்ட் போல் சேம் சேர்ந்த மாதிரி பட் ஸ்கோல் டெம்பிள் தான் இன்ஃபேக்ட் அசிந்தா பார்க்க அது இட்ஸ் ஆல்சோ சேம் திங் அது போலோ ஏய் அரிகாமி தக்கை ஒரு ரூம் அதே அண்டர் பாஸ் இருந்தால் இருக்க ரூம் ரெட்டே மாதிரி அசனாவும் இவன் அண்டர் பாஸ் இருக்கிற ரூம்லேயும் இப்போ சோசியல் இருக்கிற ரூம் உங்களை பார்த்து ரொம்ப சிறந்த சுப்பிரொழிக் ஹாஸ் பீன் வீக்கன் தட்ஸ் ஆல் சுப்பிரொழிக் ஹாஸ் பீன் வீக்கன் இன்ட்ரொழிக் ஹாஸ் பீன் சென்ட் இன் திஸ் ஸ்பீசஸ் இன் இஸ் தைன் ஸ்பீசியஸ் சுப்பிரொழிக் ஹாஸ் பீன் வீக்கன் வாட் எவர் தி क्वेश्चन இஸ் தேர் தென் இன்ட்ரொழிக் இஸ் சுஷ் பீ தி வீக்கனிங் இஸ் ஆல் தி வாட் டு சீ தேர் சுப்பிரொழிக் வீக்கனிங் ரிசெஷன் என்ன கேள்வி கேட்டிருக்காரோ சேர்த்து நீங்க Anterior position models. Just know the name, man. Hello, nobody is going to do all the same. The exams are all just for slower. You know, sometimes the question they come, oblique muscles are just very much. Right? You oblique muscles, don't tell anyone to do section, section, all these things. Your answer is, trication, anterior positioning, tucking, every muscle, weakening in a way, marginal, myotomy, tenotomy, புரியல Of course, surgery nobody is going to ask you at least. When you ask no surgical treatment, then you must utilize something. Don't leave the question that is right here. And so now, you write at least the names Kastenbaum, Anderson, Goto, Van Nuden. That is, you know the names. Then resection only. It means Kunzer is not a Kastenbaum only. Goto only resection. Anderson only resection. I will follow. You write everything obese as done and long ago. Nobody will understand what that means. So in all this time, as they obey, obey the Alexander law. What is Alexander law? I told you. Hey, Kindra, this joke. Kindi. If I want to show something, I will follow. Sure. Why? Well, honestly, அப்புறம் பாரம்பரியம் பண்ணியா உடனே போய் பார்த்தேன் அப்படின்னு பாரம்பரியம் பார்க்க மண்டல அசரம் பண்ணிருக்கேன் You will get faster, no? Go to faster. Then go to Kansky. Something was to build by something. There are so many things I have not told. But nicotine, told up nicotine. Subject this time. There are so many things like that. Even in smokers, nicotine amplifies. Even normal person, nicotine amplifies. You can see. Suppose MC will never ask the question. Nicotine, what type of this type of space they have? Subject this type of story. The character, whom? Nicotine, nah. Nicotine, no. Nicotine can produce upbeat in a normal person and even in smokers. You are a smoker, huh? Suppose you take nicotine and you have this type of person, everything will move around. The world is moving. You know, some of the things you should know.